Let's now take a look at some health headlines.
Joining us now is professor at Northwestern University Medical School and WGN Morning News medical contributor, Dr. Stryker. Good to see you again.
Good morning. Good morning.
All right, first topic, there's some benefits of intermittent fasting.
Yeah, so this has been a big buzz thing over the last few years about, is it good for you? Is it bad for you? Does it work? But there really hasn't been a very good analysis. So an analysis was just published in a journal of endocrinology that looked at about 1,000 people that had practiced intermittent fasting. And they divided them into three groups: people of normal weight, people who were overweight, and then people who had obesity. And what they found is that even the normal weight people benefit in terms of their cardiometabolic parameters, things like glucose levels, triglycerides, cholesterol. The people that benefited the most was the overweight crowd, because not only did they lose significant weight, but they also had better cardiometabolic parameters. The group that maybe didn't benefit as much are people with obesity. While they did lose some weight and they did have some improvement, it was not as dramatic as the overweight crowd. But the point is it wasn't bad for anybody. A lot of people benefited. They looked at a lot of different protocols. The one that seemed to be the best is where you eat for 8 hours and you fast for 16 hours, which sounds like it's really hard to do, but if you have an early dinner and you're done by 6, 7 o'clock, that just means you're kind of, you know, skipping
the morning.
So it's something to think about doing, and not necessarily every day, even just a few times a week can be beneficial.
All right.
All right. Up next, a dangerous time of year for heart attacks.
Yeah, the week between Christmas and January 1st can be a real killer, because it turns out that that is the most likely time to die from a heart attack.
Get out, for real.
I didn't even know this. The American Heart Association came out talking about the fact that, you know, this people are overeating, of course, and drinking too much. No surprise, that all makes sense, that there's stress levels from the holiday stuff and the travel and the family. But this is what really seems to be what makes the difference. People are ignoring the signs, the warnings, because you're at the Christmas party, you get a little chest pain, you get some arm pain, you say, I'm not leaving the party and going and sitting in the emergency room. I'm going to wait till later, or you're out of town. You don't want to interrupt your holiday plans. So, yes, the message is, of course, you know, try and moderate what you're eating and drinking, and try not to get too stressed out by your crazy family that you can't stand and all of that. But if you are having chest pain, shortness of breath, arm pain, nausea, it may not be from something you were eating. You know, don't ignore this stuff. Get yourself to an emergency room, because evidently a lot of people die of heart attacks during this very specific time.
All right, a new study about telehealth sites selling men testosterone.
Yeah, I mean, you've seen the commercials, right?
Right.
If you're a guy who's got fatigue, low libido, call this toll-free number and we will be delivering testosterone right to your door. So a study was just released in JAMA, and this was done by urologist at Northwestern, Justin Dubin, who's a urologist who posed as a fake patient. And basically, he called these telehealth companies and said, hey, I'm, you know, a 37-year-old guy, and my libido's not so great, and I'm, you know, feeling kind of tired. And they said, well, what are your testosterone levels? And he would say, well, I checked them, and they're actually normal. Didn't matter. They were willing to prescribe anyway. Mm-hmm. But even worse is they found that 86% of these companies, they called lots of companies posing as a fake patient, would inappropriately prescribe testosterone to people who either wouldn't benefit or might be harmed. So as an example, if you're a 37-year-old guy and you're interested in getting pregnant, if you're interested in fertility, if you take testosterone, it will make your sperm count plummet. Nobody asked this 37-year-old guy. They were just happy to prescribe testosterone.
Wow.
So there were a lot of issues, too. Besides, that was just one example.
Yeah.
But the point is that these telehealth companies, they are not in the business of practicing medicine.
Yeah.
They are in the business of selling product.
Yeah.
If somebody comes to my office and I write a prescription, I don't make any money from writing that prescription. You know, the telehealth companies don't make money from having the conversation. They make money from that's selling, and it's not just testosterone. You know, I see this in the menopause world with estrogen and all that. So buyer beware. If you're talking to a telehealth company that is trying to sell you product, they may not be having your best medical interests at heart, and a lot of bad stuff is going on.
All right. Well, for more, you can check out Dr. Stryker on social media. There's all the places you can find her. Thanks for being here again.
Thank you.
Thanks for being here.
And hey, send a note to Pat and Paul, right, Mike?
That's